Welcome to a lesson on unit conversions. In this lesson, we will focus on non-standard units of measure. We will perform the conversions using unit fractions. In the first example, Farmer Tom has a barter system where 4 pigs equals 9 ducks, 1 goat equals 3 ducks, and 2 pigs equals 5 chickens. The first question is, for part A, Farmer Tom needs to figure out how many chickens he can trade for 6 goats. Another way to write this is, 6 goats equals how many chickens? To begin, we'll write 6 goats as a fraction with the denominator of 1. From here, we multiply by unit fractions, convert goats to chickens. We form the unit fractions using the conversions shown here. Because 1 goat equals 3 ducks, we can use this conversion to write a unit fraction to convert goats to ducks. Because we want goats to simplify out, and right now we have goats in the numerator, for the unit fraction we need goats in the denominator, so that goats simplify out. Because the conversion is 1 goat equals 3 ducks, we have the unit of ducks in the numerator, and the conversion is 3 ducks equals 1 goat. Because these are equal, this quotient is equal to 1. So multiplying by this unit fraction does not change the value, it just changes the units. Notice goats divided by goats simplifies to 1. But our goal is to have chickens, not ducks, so now we'll multiply by another unit fraction. Using the conversion, 4 pigs equals 9 ducks. Because we want ducks to simplify out, we must have ducks in the denominator. Because ducks are in the numerator here, the conversion is 4 pigs equals 9 ducks, so we have pigs in the numerator, and the conversion is 4 pigs equals 9 ducks. The units of ducks simplify out or simplify to 1. Now we have pigs, but we still want chickens. So we'll use the final conversion to multiply by one more unit fraction using the conversion 2 pigs equals 5 chickens. We want pigs to simplify out, so we have pigs in the denominator and chickens in the numerator. The conversion is 2 pigs equals 5 chickens, so the unit fraction is 5 chickens divided by 2 pigs. The units of pigs simplify out or simplify to 1. Notice now we are left with the units of chickens, which is what we want. So now we multiply the fractions. We could simplify before multiplying, but let's go ahead and multiply the numerators and multiply the denominators. So 6 times 3 times 4 times 5 equals 360. And 1 times 1 times 9 times 2 is equal to 18. 360 divided by 18 is equal to 20. So now we know that 6 goats equals 20 chickens. Let's look at some more examples. Here we have the same barter system with some additional conversions. For A, how many goats can be traded for 18 geese? So we begin with 18 geese as a fraction with a denominator of 1. We want to convert geese to goats. So on the far right, we have a certain number of goats, which we will determine. Now we need to figure out which conversions to use. We begin with geese, and notice how here's a conversion that says 5 ducks equals 6 geese, and here's another that says 1 cow equals 12 geese. If we convert to cows, though, there are no other conversions that we can use, and therefore we'll use the conversion 5 ducks equals 6 geese to begin. Because we want the units of geese to simplify out, we multiply by a unit fraction where we have geese in the denominator and ducks in the numerator. The conversion is 5 ducks equals 6 geese, so the unit fraction is 5 ducks divided by 6 geese. The units of geese simplify out, leaving us with ducks. Now we look for a conversion involving ducks that we can hopefully use to convert to goats. Notice how here we're given 1 goat equals 3 ducks, and therefore we can multiply by one more unit fraction to convert ducks to goats. We want ducks to simplify out, so we must have ducks in the denominator, and we will have goats in the numerator. The conversion is 1 goat equals 3 ducks, and therefore the unit fraction is 1 goat divided by 3 ducks. The units of ducks simplify to 1. And now we multiply the fractions. Again, we could simplify before multiplying. Let's just go ahead and multiply. In the numerator, we have 18 times 5, which equals 90. In the denominator, we have 6 times 3, which equals 18. 90 divided by 18 is equal to 5, and therefore 8 geese equals 5 goats. To answer the question, how many goats can be traded for 18 geese? We now know the answer is 5 goats. For part B, if you need 10 horses, how many pigeons would you need to barter? To answer this question, we'll convert 10 horses to pigeons. Looking at the conversions, we can use the conversion 5 horses equals 3 bulls to convert horses to bulls. And then we can use the conversion 1 bull equals 32 pigeons to convert bulls to pigeons. So for the first unit fraction, because you want horses to simplify out, we need horses in the denominator. And because the conversion is 5 horses equals 3 bulls, we have bulls in the numerator. And the unit fraction is 3 bulls divided by 5 horses. Notice now the units of horses simplify out or simplify to 1. And now we'll use a conversion 1 bull equals 32 pigeons to convert bulls to pigeons and answer our question. We want bulls to simplify out, so bulls must be in the denominator. And we have pigeons in the numerator. The conversion is 1 bull equals 32 pigeons, and therefore the unit fraction is 32 pigeons divided by 1 bull. The units of bulls simplify to 1. Now we multiply the fractions, which will tell us how many pigeons we need to barter for 10 horses. Multiplying the numerators, we have 10 times 3 times 32, which equals 960. In the denominator, we have 1 times 5 times 1, which equals 5. 960 divided by 5 is equal to 192. So now we know 10 horses equals 192 pigeons. Going back to the question, if you need 10 horses, how many pigeons would you need to barter? And the answer is 192 pigeons. I hope you found this helpful.